Hey, everyone, and welcome to the WNBA on 2K Sports. And tonight, it'll be the Atlanta Dream going up against the Minnesota Lynx. Courtside with Tim Schwartz and Brian Benefitemi, I'm Blake Suniga, and we've got a fun one. Well, we know the history between these teams. They see each other just twice a year. Tim, how loud is this arena going to be?
Very loud. Just an awesome environment expected tonight in this arena. They've been talking about this one all week in the local papers and talk shows. It has the feel of a big postseason game.
Yeah, and they don't face off much, so it has an extra special feel to it, and I just can't wait to see how it goes tonight. As always, we just want a close game.
Now here's Williams. Here's Hayes. It's good, and she makes her first shot of the game.
Well, a quick first step is only a part of what makes Hayes so elusive.
It's Danielle Robinson on the wing. She's guarded by Hayes. Here's Collier. And that one's good. Fouls.
What a motor. Fouls, one of the best in the league at converting second chances.
Outside Williams. McCautry. Six on the shot clock. For three, Renee Montgomery. And she's good on the three ball.
I love how Montgomery picks her spots on the court. Knows which shots to take and not to take.
Now here's Moore. Three-pointer. And it's Collier missing. Outside Hayes. And first quarter of action, 2 minutes in.
Right here, right here.
Outside Williams. And stolen by Maya Moore. Pass for Robinson. Sims. Back to Robinson. That one a little long.
Not sure what the D was doing there. She's not the player to give open looks to, but they got away with it that time.
Outside Hayes. Back to Montgomery. Over Robinson, and Atlanta, another bucket.
Aware of all moving parts on the court, Montgomery is a fundamentally sound guard who can excel in the pick and roll.
Now here is Sims. Fouls. She's guarded by Williams. Tries it from 19. Elizabeth Williams pulls it in. Atlanta in the lead. And they have certainly been looking locked in offensively.
They sure have, staying aggressive and playing in control.
Outside Hayes. Back to McCautry. Yes, and a nice assist from Tiffany Hayes.
It's impossible to understate McCautry's value to her team. She's coordinated and poised on the offensive end.
Now here is Sims, looking for her first basket still in this one. Her first shot is a miss, 0 for 1 to start the contest. To the paint, and lots of contact there. Missing the shot, and we'll shoot two at the line. It's going to be on Sylvia Fouls.
A very difficult matchup. Williams is 6'3 with elite athleticism. Can cause opponents to foul. One of the more physical bigs, Elizabeth is a nightmare to try and score. She puts her athleticism on full display when she rejects shot after shot.
She misses the free throw. Yeah, we all know Williams is a great shot blocker, but she does so much more than that.
Yeah, Elizabeth is truly a relentless rebounder. With timing and recognition, she chases boards down beautifully.
She hits the second from the line.
Drafted in the top five in the 2015 draft by Connecticut, Elizabeth Williams really struggled as a rookie. But after a change of scenery getting traded to Atlanta, she was the 2016 WNBA Most Improved Player.
Minnesota calls a timeout.
Well, the Lynx have had so many leaders during their fantastic run as a franchise, but right now, you have to say this is Maya Moore's team, and she just does so much as a leader on both ends of the floor.
Outside Sims. It's Danielle Robinson on the wing. She's guarded by Hayes.
Tries to snap the cold streak.
Sims with the bucket. And Moore, the versatile small forward. She can dominate in so many ways.
Maya has those quick hands on defense and gets you so many extra possessions. Great spot-up shooter from outside. Very hard to keep in front of you also when she drives to the basket. Their first miss of the game, a strong start.
Pass to Collier. Yes, great play by Odyssey Sims to set it up.
Well, what you're seeing right now is Sims' playmaking ability on full display. She sees things that other players don't.
Robinson. With the putback, great positioning on the putback. It's a tie ball game.
She's now 3-for-4 from the field, and it looks like she is in her bag offensively.
Outside Hayes. Back to Montgomery. Just 5 to shoot. Over Robinson. The dream again can't hit. From 12 feet out, it's rebounded by Atlanta. Montgomery outside. Here's McCautry, and Maya Moore with the block. Outside Robinson. Takes it out to Collier. Moore, covered by McCautry. From downtown, up again, controls the rebound and puts it back up and in. And the dream call time here.
The coaches, they saw their team giving up a lot of points and wanted to get a break before it got out of hand.
And that's a big part of a coach's job, making sure you keep your players in the best position possible at all times. That's a great timeout.
group getting ready for the Dream.
The Dream Trail. Sykes outside, pass to Bentley. Back to Sykes. Six to shoot. Here's Billings.
To end the run!
And it's good on the layup.
I'm not sure, really, in that set who was supposed to be on her there. And apparently, neither did the defenders.
Now Dantas. Pass to Fouls. And count the basket. She was fouled, and she's going to the line for one more.
What an impressive career Fouls has had. Multiple championships, finals, MVPs, and all-star nods. And she's done it with a strong presence in the paint. Scoring, shot blocking, you name it, inside, she's done it.
Mind the lanes. Mind the lanes. One shot.
And with Fouls, she's not only an icon in the league, she's a terrific teammate as well.
Yeah, she's more than willing to act as a mentor for others because people see her success and want to emulate it. So to me, Sylvia is nothing short of a class act as she brings the intensity of both ends, night in and night out.
Five to shoot. Pass to Sykes. From deep. The shot, no good. Great D that time from Karima Christmas Kelly. Makes it off the glass.
So tough, so strong. Christmas Kelly is one of the shorter front court players, but she takes it strong when she gets inside.
Here's Billings. Excellent D there from Odyssey Sims. The Lynx with the lead. And they have certainly been looking locked in offensively.
They sure have, staying aggressive and playing in control.
Pass to Augustus. Inside, Sims. That falls. Nice lead that time from Sylvia Fouls.
And now we see them really working it inside.
Yeah, getting quality looks around the rim. That's fueling this run.
Now here is Bentley. Quiet so far offensively, searching for her first points of the game. To stop the run, buries the jump shot.
Well, she's an old school two guard. Bentley is out there looking for her shot. Makes her tough to stop.
Sims with it. Bentley picks her up. Pass to Sims. With the floater. And it's Atlanta with the rebound.
Great defense right there to prevent one of the best finishers in the league from converting in close.
She's a very strong finisher on the fast break.
And always in control, even at full speed like that.
So impressive.
Now here is Sims. Dantas. Pass to Augustus. Fouls. Good on the shot.
Every time they get scored on during this run, it seems like it's come from inside the paint. Buckle up on defense.
Yeah, it's time to collapse down and make them shoot jumpers.
Now here is Sykes. Over Augustus. Can't cash in the 10-foot jumper. 7-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. To the middle. Fouls can't get it to go.
Nice work there to contest the finish inside.
Yeah, they got the shot they wanted, but her defense laid waste to those plans.
Here's Augustus. It's deflected. Outside, Bentley. Coffee. And once again, off the mark by Atlanta. That one is off. And that concludes the first quarter of play. The Lynx on top, up by 5. And the second quarter about to get started. We'll be back in a moment. And the first quarter in the books, second about to get underway. And from what we've seen from the Lynx, what's your take so far?
Really putting in the work on the offensive glass.
They've set the tone here early with a hustle.
Well, you look at the strengths of this Atlanta Dream Team, and it starts with Tiffany Hayes, pairing her up with McCautry, the clear core of the Dream.
She did double duty right there. Influenced the shot and cleaned the glass.
Now here's Christmas Kelly. Not a lot of room. Pass to Augustus. Over Sykes. Augustus, no good. As you said, the wing pair of Hayes and McCautry make for a fearsome duo.
Yeah, the team looks so dangerous when both are healthy and on the floor. And these two just provide so much in terms of playmaking and rebounding. And they're as talented a wing pair as we have in the entire league.
Just two to shoot. And the basket by Bentley.
A combination of smarts, desire, fearlessness. And that's what you need if you want to score down low at 5'7 in the WNBA like Bentley.
Here's Talbot. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for her. Dantas outside. Off to a good start as she hits her first shot attempt.
She just used her height that time down low. That's a pretty hard play to defend against.
And they could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Yeah, too many empty possessions. I mean, it's simple. They need points.
And the call is going to be, yep, an illegal screen.
You have to make sure your feet are set. But when you set those screens, they'll get you for it.
I thought maybe she was set. Now, I know that's a difficult call to make, but I think maybe they got that one wrong.
Augustus outside, pass to Talbot. Here's Fagbenle. She's guarded by Hayes. For three, Maya Moore. Gulich with the rebound. Atlanta trailing here. Let's it go! And it's Hayes missing.
That's too good a look to pass up there, despite the result.
Here's Talbot. He's guarded by Hayes. And it's Collier missing.
She thought she had a clear path to the hoop, but great work by the D to cut her off.
Montgomery right side. McCautry left side. And once again, off the mark by Atlanta. So the Lynx now. They've only given up 2 points this quarter. Augustus outside, down low. Talbot, and you can count it. She'll go to the line with a chance to make it three.
Great find by Augustus. So many seasons in the league, she is cognizant of open teammates.
Now, about midway through the season, a couple teams are starting to slide, desperate to turn things around.
Well, it's a tough season to get through physically, but also mentally. You know, the biggest test is when things go wrong. Are you going to bounce back stronger than ever?
No one likes losing. These are the best athletes in the world. And when you start losing, you need to continue to work, continue to stay positive, and eventually you hope the results will come.
For the Dream, the problem in games is rarely their defense. In fact, they're usually very strong on that end of the court. And I would say when they lose, it's more because their offense comes up short.
Now here is Hayes. And fouled hard that time. And she'll get two shots at the line. As you said with the Dream, they'll go as far as their offense takes them.
And the team can really struggle with efficiency at times. They can score in bunches, but over the course of the season, can end up near the bottom. Trouble at the line, and really from deep as well.
Throw is good.
Well, hard to call the last decade of the Lynx anything other than a dynasty. Won titles in 2011, 2013, 2015, 2017. Not bad grabbing a ring every other year.
That misses, so she splits the free throws. And for the 2010s, a decade of dominance for the Lynx, as you said.
Yeah, you look at the talent they had during that stretch, Blake. It was unreal. So many stars and key players at every position. And the big thing is they all bought into the system and played for each other.
Good.
A focal point of opposing game plans, McCautry just wants to find the open teammate. She's a willing distributor.
Now here's Moore. She hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. Here's Talbot. Pass to Fagmanley. Let's loose for three. And it's Hayes with the rebound. The Dream on offense. McCautry covered by Moore. Now here is McCautry, guarded closely. Williams gets it to go.
She worked so hard on her post moves, her finishing. Williams thrives close to the hoop.
Here's Talbot. Pass to Collier. Here's Montgomery. 5 points in the game. Freeland outside. Montgomery. Left side, Williams. Four on the shot clock. Baseline Jay on the way. That's a miss. She's made one and missed one. Here's Talbot. Freeland defending. Pass to Collier. Outside Moore. And again, no good by Minnesota. McCautry outside. Now here's Montgomery. Outside Hayes. Freeland. Here's McCautry. The second chance effort. They shoot again. So the whistle blows on the shot. Two free throws for the contact there.
Well versed at operating around the basket, Freeland's aggressive attitude is such a key cog for her team. Well, Jessica Freeland is one of the top shot blockers in the WNBA, but her journey to the league is even more impressive. Before her senior year at North Carolina, Freeland was diagnosed with cancer.
The first one falls. And that journey for Jessica Freeland, at only 21 years old, she had to endure chemotherapy for Hodgkin's lymphoma.
And not only did Freeland recover, she was drafted in 2011 into the WNBA. Named to All-Star and All-Defensive teams, Freeland's story inspires others.
She hits both from the stripe.
An all-defensive first-team selection just proves how admired Breland's defensive intensity is around the league.
Sims with it, and it's Montgomery picking her up. Pass to Moore. Back to Fowles. And again, unable to change momentum here. Montgomery with it. Williams. McCautry outside. Another shot. And it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
Relishing on undisciplined defenders, McCautry loves to capitalize on the defense's mistakes.
And this is her first free throw of the game. This next one could give them the lead.
I continue to be impressed with McCautry's defense. Now, she moves her feet well to stay in front of opponents, and with her active hands, she's able to make a lot of steals.
And that one drops, so they lead by one. And thinking of Angel McCautry, she's got to be considered one of the best two-way players in the league,
yeah,
right?
No doubt, Blake. Her defense is great. But McCautry's offense always has to be accounted for as well. Such an expansive skill set. She's no easy cover. Two words to describe her: difference maker.
And it's Renee Montgomery penetrating. Williams inside, covered by Fowles. Outside Hayes, over Robinson, got it. She's now 3 for 5 from the field.
Well, with increasing scoring averages nearly every season in the league, Hayes' work ethic is inspiring.
Minnesota calls a timeout.
You know, it's such a joy watching Hayes and her versatility. Instead of a signature move, her biggest strength is not really having a weakness.
Robinson up top. She's guarded by Hayes. Back to Sims. Clock at 6. Robinson comes up empty down low.
You know, typically she has the touch to finish when she's in that tight. Not sure what happened there.
Now here is Sykes, covered by Moore. Minnesota trailing. Pass to Sims. Now Robinson. Dantas outside. For three, Maya Moore gets that one to drop. First of the game after 4 straight misses.
An absolute gym rat. Moore has spent countless hours perfecting her craft, especially her 3 ball.
Now here is Hayes. She has 7. And the foul on Robinson. That's her first foul.
Defense!
here is Sykes. She's guarded closely to the inside. And Williams gets it to go.
That's not an easy hoop. Good concentration by Williams to get the bucket. A focused player.
Augustus up top. That shot, no good. Great D that time from Brittany Sykes. Pass to Bentley. Billings, she's guarded by Dantas. Just five on the clock. Here's Sykes. The shot that time, not on target. Now the Lynx take it the other way. Augustus with the ball. Outside Sims. Fouls. Back to Sims. Launches a three. In it goes. That's her third bucket. And she's missed five so far.
An impact perimeter player. Sims uses a mature feel for the game to score points.
3 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Here's Sykes. And she's got her first free throws of the night right here. The first.
The fourth overall pick by Atlanta in 2017. Brittany Sykes has been brought in to do one thing, score, and she has provided a punch.
And good on both. Outside Sims. Yep, that goes.
A notable finisher around the rim. Sims doesn't want any weak spots in her game, and I admire that.
And the first half comes to an end. We've got a close game going on here. Lynx ahead. They're up by one. And time now for the halftime break with the third quarter soon to follow on 2K Sports. We have a close ball game on our hands as we get set for the second half to get underway. Fouls has been sensational.
What a first half it was for her, well surpassing her average point totals up to this stage.
Yeah, she's on pace for a monster game.
Atlanta trailing here.
And Simone Augustus here in action tonight, one of the most lethal perimeter players the league has ever seen. Now she's in the twilight of her career, but guess what? She can still take over a game.
Outside Sims. Pass to Robinson. Back to Sims. Collier outside. Four on the clock. Now here's Moore. Breland defending. And that one goes long. Well, with Augustus, she is so hard to contain. Hurts you in so many ways.
Look, Augustus is a fantastic jumper paired with a mean first step and crossover. It's so fun to watch. And if you go small on her, she'll drag the defender down to the post. And just absolute ice in her veins as well. So many clutch shots in her career.
Now here is Sims. 9 points in the game. Collier outside. Pass to Fouls. It's rebounded by Atlanta. 90 seconds into the second half now. Back to Montgomery. Hayes. Here's the three. Fouls with the rebound.
Just like me. 9 times out of 10, she's going to bury the three when she's left all alone like that.
It's Danielle Robinson on the wing. Breland defending. Here's Robinson. Buries the triple. Wow. Here's Montgomery. He has 5. Pass to Williams. Now here is McCautry, covered by Moore. Outside Hayes. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Over Robinson. Williams. The tip in off the offensive boards.
Like she's on a pogo stick. Williams up for the board, down a moment, then up for the points. What energy!
Moore with it. Collier outside. Pass to Sims. To the paint. Got a piece of it. Moore. Over Breland. Tried to bank it in, but he misses.
Man, and they're 1-for-4 to start the second half.
And here's McCautry. And here's Breland. Montgomery outside. Back to Breland, over Sims. Minnesota grabs the miss. Outside Moore, Sims, Breland defending. Pass to Fouls, over Montgomery. Another one falls for Minnesota.
She's created some good opportunities for herself and made the most of them.
Cautry up top. And the layup's good off the glass.
What sets McCautry apart from other players is her will to win. Loves to compete until the ref blows the whistle.
Back to Sims. And good. Coming off the assist by Danielle Robinson.
They can't afford to give her that kind of look.
Well, it came off a good screen, but still, as a defender, you have to fight over the top of it.
And you need some help as well.
Now here is Hayes. She has 7. Collier with it. Now guarded by McCautry. Right side Sims. Pass to Fouls. Back to Sims. Moore. The shot's good.
Looks like they left their defensive effort back in the locker room. They just haven't had the same commitment to defense here in the second.
Well, I never thought Odyssey Sims got the credit she deserved for winning a national title in college, but I guess that's what happens when you play alongside Brittany Griner. But make no mistake about it, Sims was the heart and soul of that team.
The Lynx leading. Pass to Robinson. Down low.
Get it.
Sims, Montgomery covering.
The offensive rebound.
And that one's good.
Fouls.
Four of their last five makes came off a high quality shot inside.
And that's right out of the textbook. They're having their way down low right now.
Atlanta calls timeout. And Sims really shined during her senior season.
Well, after Griner went first overall in the 2013 draft, Sims scored nearly 30 points per game her senior season without Britton, showing she could carry a team. And WNBA team certainly took notice. Sims went second overall in the 2014 draft.
Lynx on D. A 4-point game. Outside Bentley. Pass to Coffey. Sykes with the ball. Christmas Kelly covering. Five on the clock. Sykes with the ball. Working on Dantas. Sykes, no good. And these guys have had some good motion on offense. Nice assists.
When everybody's involved offensively, it's in a way helping you defensively too.
Now here is Bentley. Pass to Sykes. Billings. Here's Bentley. Gulich covered by fouls. Gulich's shot is off. Now the Lynx with it. 6-point lead. Now here is Augustus. Pass to Dantas. Christmas Kelly. And here is Augustus. Over Bentley. And it's Minnesota scoring again.
It seems that every pass they make is leading to a score here. Just phenomenal ball movement.
Everyone's looking for the best shot, and it's paid off during this run.
Now here is Bentley. Sykes outside. And Sylvia fouls with the swat.
Just so dominant. Fouls has won multiple Defensive Player of the Year awards for a reason.
Bentley, no good. Sylvia fouls into the lane. Count it.
They've had assists now on their last three baskets.
Everybody always thinks it's passing that gets you assists, but also their movement off the ball, it's created those opportunities.
Here's Billings. Sykes, guarded by Augustus. They need this. And she gets it to go, hitting off the back of the rim.
That's why Bentley has been an all-star. She can just focus on the hoop. Forget about the good defense in front of you. Just knock it down.
And the Atlanta Dream get their wins through their defense. You know, force a lot of turnovers with the pressure they put on. And they just do a great job of closing out on shooters and challenging every shot.
Now here is Bentley. She's got six. Inside, Coffey. The layup off target. Christmas Kelly outside. That one goes in. And with the defense of the Dream, some great shot blocking as well.
Breland and Williams, both fantastic rim protectors. The whole group does a good job of getting a hand up on every attempt. Atlanta has built their team around defense.
Now here is Sykes. Pass to Billings. And here is Bentley, guarded by Augustus. Fires the three, and Alex Bentley gets the three.
That three is one reason why it's so hard to guard Bentley. She's not a sharpshooter. Still, she can knock those down. Gives you another thing to worry about defensively.
Now here is Augustus. And it's good. Off the back of the rim and in.
Whatever their plan was defensively that time, it did not work. Not if it results in that shot.
Sykes with the ball. Left side, Bentley. Pass to Gulich. Sykes. Over Augustus. Sykes, no good.
Boy, the complexion of this game would be a whole lot different if she had shot the ball anything like she's capable of.
Talbot, defended by Bentley. Now fouls. Here's Talbot. The three. It's not going to go for her. The third quarter comes to a close. The Lynx on top, leading by nine. And we're coming right back. Be sure to stay with us as we get set for the fourth quarter. Hello, and thanks for joining us again. The fourth quarter of play should begin in moments. Now Sims. It's Simone Augustus on the wing. Pass to Dantas. Now Sims. She's guarded by Williams. Shot clock at five. Shot from the wing. And she tries off the glass, but it's no good. Now here is McCautry. Second shot opportunity, and that one goes in as she's fouled. It'll be 3 points if she can convert the free throw.
Few players bring their team together like Angel McCautry does. A supportive teammate, she really knows how to get the best out of every member of her squad.
One shot.
Yeah, guys, I'd say Angel is the veteran leader every team dreams of having.
Absolutely. Learning the game from Angel is invaluable experience. She plays a great role model for players just entering the league.
Now here's Moore. Pass to Fagbenle. Augustus. Now here's Dantas. Bentley with the rebound. Sykes outside. Fourth quarter, still young, just over a minute played. Misses the layup. She had her with that pump fake, but couldn't make her pay. Here's Fagbenle. Pass to Moore. And here is Augustus. Here's Moore, covered by McCautry. Here's Moore. She's covered closely. Great D that time from Brittany Sykes. Now here is Bentley. She's covered by Sims. Sykes with the ball. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass.
even at 5'9", no fear from Sykes. She plays way bigger than her height. Tremendous heart.
The Lynx leading. Pass to Dantas. Moore. Knocked loose. It's stolen by Bentley. Now here is Sykes, guarded by Augustus. Sykes with the bucket.
All quarter, she's been zeroed in, locked in, focused, and she's knocked down big shots for her team in the fourth.
It's Maya Moore on the wing, covered by McCautry. Augustus outside. Sims. And the Lynx miss again.
She's tried to get it going, but the shots simply haven't been dropping for her.
McCautry outside. Side Hayes.
And it's all evened up.
Those defenders look a little bit gassed. I mean, they're just getting pushed around on the low block. Maybe coach has got to make a substitution or something to energize his team.
Well, they better rally soon. They've given up three straight buckets in the paint.
Now here is Augustus. Pass to Fagmenle. Five to shoot. Here's Sims.
Trying to get back on track. A nice shot by Fagmenle.
Such a grinder, always doing the dirty work on the offensive glass. That's what she brings to the table.
Montgomery outside. Breland. Over Collier. Misses off the right iron. Here's Minnesota. Pass to Sims.
Yo, look this way.
Moore with it. Montgomery covering.
Count it! And the foul!
It's going to be on Angel McCautry.
The ability to finish with finesse or power makes Moore such a tough cover. And guys, for Maya Moore, a laundry list of accolades. She's got WNBA titles, MVP awards, all-star nods, you name it. And really, by pretty much everyone's account, she's a terrific teammate and mentor.
And that one misses. And this is what you want from a veteran leader. Moore makes everyone around her better.
Her standard of excellence sets a great example. Consistently, one of the league's best scorers. Dependable, responsible. That's why so many young players around the league look up to Maya Moore.
Here's Williams.
Go, get it.
And the foul called on Collier. That'll be her second foul of the game. And so here's Atlanta. Here in the fourth, they've only allowed just 4 points. And out of bounds, the Lynx will take it. Plenty of drama in this one so far.
Well, hopefully, from our standpoint at least, don't be surprised if it isn't decided until the final buzzer.
We can only hope. Here Sims finds the bottom of the bucket from about 13 feet out.
A disciplined player with a consistent offensive attack. Sims alters the game in so many different ways.
Renee Montgomery, she's open. Yes, and a nice assist from Tiffany Hayes.
Perfect screen there. Set her up with a terrific look.
Yeah, but that's a bad job by the defender to not fight through that screen to contest.
You want to see more effort there.
Now here is Sims. Over Montgomery. Fouls, that's good.
Of their last six baskets, five have come on the interior. This is smash-mouth basketball, guys.
Yeah, they're really imposing their will offensively and getting exactly the kind of looks they want.
And the dream call time here.
And for Atlanta, they're still looking for that first title. Remember, they lost in the finals three times now, and it's really not an easy hill to get over.
Presentation of our Jordan player of the game,
Sylvia Fouls.
Well, her accuracy has been a needle in the side of this defense. They've tried to bring help, they've tried to deny, they've tried to disrupt. But guess what? She's a machine. She will not have it.
Atlanta trailing here. And for the dream, it shows the sustained success of the franchise.
Yeah, I'm not a big participation trophy guy, Blake, but losing in three finals means you at least got to three finals, and how many teams can say that, right? But look, at the end of the day, it stings that they were swept out of all of those appearances, but I still feel like this team is on the verge of greatness.
Pass to Moore. They waste no time getting those 3 points back.
An exceptional shooter. Moore is shifty and doesn't need much time to get her shot off.
And stolen by Sims. Now here's Collier. Moore. The putback, it's good on the putback.
Well, when you can't box out, bad things are bound to happen.
If you give any team more than one chance in the offensive end, you are just begging for trouble.
Now here is Hayes. And here's McCautry. Shot clock at six. From way back. Shot will not fall. And Minnesota the other way now. Outside Sims. And it's Atlanta with the rebound.
She is going to buy herself a ticket to the bench if she keeps shooting like she has this quarter so far.
Montgomery outside. Pass to Hayes. Shoots the three. She scores her fifth field goal, and she's taken nine shots to get there.
So mature mentally and emotionally, Hayes stays composed throughout the game.
Here's Sims, and there's the whistle on the shot. Took the foul, shot misses, and she'll shoot two. And Atlanta gets called for the foul.
Odyssey Sims, two shots.
First one falls for her.
Making the all-rookie team after a strong first-year campaign, Sims wasted no time once she entered the WNBA.
And she makes both free throws. McCautry with it. Launches it. Rebound by the Lynx.
Closing down on leads is done by making smart plays on offense and taking care of the rock. It's not done by hoisting up bonehead threes like that one.
Now here is Sims. Up top Moore. Poked away and stolen by Montgomery. Lays it in off the breakaway.
Using active hands to disrupt opponents. That's a big part of Montgomery's game, wouldn't you say?
To the middle. And that one's good. Collier. Here's McCautry. Out to the left wing. And stolen by Maya Moore. Drops in the breakaway layup.
Well, we talked about the defensive acumen of Moore, and I think it has to do with her quick hands. She uses them well.
Montgomery outside. And it's off from three-point range. Outside Moore. Pass to Fouls. Robinson. He's guarded by Hayes. Here's Sims. Down to five on the shot clock. It's hauled in by Williams.
Yeah, and ever since halftime, she's been ice cold. Very little going her way out there.
Montgomery outside. McCautry, no good.
It's almost like she's trying to make things hard on herself. Work it around, get an easier shot.
Here's Moore. So we see the Lynx get the win here. Even early on in this one, it seemed like they were happy to be playing at home tonight.
It makes a big difference. Once they started to really play in a good flow, you felt like they never had any doubts that they'd come out on top.
And that'll wrap it up.